Hello students. So all NEET preparing students, welcome back to a session where we are going to discuss 5 golden questions from physics. Now, what is the meaning of golden question? Let me first tell you 1 or 2 facts and then I'll come on to this topic. First thing is that these questions be prepared keeping in mind the importance of topics. You know, in your NEET exam where there are 45 questions from physics, from chemistry, geology, botany, there are certain topics from which you can say, okay, with sure shot, I'm sure the question will come from there. So this way we are trying to mention some important topic, that is first aspect. So in that reference, they are golden question, because I'm trying to give you a feeling that these are important aspect of your chapters or your course curricula. Second is, in Misostudy.com website, we have lot of supportive material for you, crash course, regular material. So as and when you need, please feel free to visit our website and you, accordingly you can find your own material as per your requirement. Fine. So very soon we are also going to launch these type of things for your 2020 exam. So this is the main idea of these videos. Okay. So I think let's start. And it's not like that I will explain the question and solution. No, I will mention the importance of that particular topic from which I picked the question. Okay. So let's start watching this set of golden questions. This is question number 1. First, I want to tell you, in your class 11th in thermodynamics, there is a very important topic, calorimetry. Fine. Now, in calorimetry, there is a very good probability that you will get a question. So, on the basis of the analysis of previous year papers, pattern of various medical entrance exams, we picked this type of question. What I mentioned over here, that is, you have 2 liquids. Liquid A, quantity 100 gram and temperature 100 degree centigrade. Actually, rather than writing long, you can say language, I'm trying to mention the question in a very simple format. So liquid A 100 gram at 100 degree centigrade mixed or added in another liquid B, which has quantity 50 gram and temperature 75 degree centigrade. So definitely we will get a mixture of A and B, and then mixture temperature is 90 degree. So now, what with surety you can say, liquid A losing heat energy and liquid B is attaining heat energy. That is simple. Okay. Now, what will be temperature of mixture if 100 gram of liquid A at 100 degree centigrade, same values, added with 50 gram of liquid B at 50 degree centigrade. So there is only one difference, this temperature. Got that idea? So you can say 2 simple questions combined together. So in calorimetry, what is the you can say basic formula? Heat added by heat achieved by. Fine. So directly I am writing M S delta T is equal to, with yellow color, M S delta T. Please, please, please wait. A B, sorry, sorry, sorry. A and A means mass of liquid A, specific you can say heat capacity of liquid A and temperature. Then B B B. Clear? So let me allow to put the values. So as per the question, 100 into SA, fine. What is the temperature? That is 100. Fine. So let me allow to put this temperature in this manner. Why? From 100 it is moving to lower temperature 90, is equal to how much? 50 into SB into what is the temperature? Now the temperature is how much? Earlier it was 75, now it is 90. So it is 90 minus 75. Clear? Now, what we will get after solving it? We will get a relation between SA and SB, because already I solved that. So, directly I am writing 4SA is equal to 3SB. Let us say this is equation number 1. Fine. So, please allow me to write down this equation over here. 4SA is equal to 3SB. As and when required, we will use this relation. Now, I am removing this. Once again, I have to put the values over here once again. So, this is again 100 SA. Fine. Now, it is losing the temperature 100, and now final is 50. So, you should write it as 100 minus 50. Fine. And sorry, I think I should mention the final step. There is no point of writing it again and again. 100 minus T. Fine. Because we have to find the new temperature of mixture. So, let us say the new temperature of the mixture is T. Fine. I think now you are comfortable with this. So, 50 gram into SB, and then T obviously is more than 50, T minus 50. Clear? Because it is at 50, so it will definitely achieve some temperature. Now, once I will solve it, again I will get a relation in SA, SB and T. And SASB value I can use from here, SA is equal to 3 by 4SB or so on. So, after solving this, I will get the result of T is equal to, that is 80 degree centigrade. Fine, I am not solving each and every step, because you may feel the teacher is wasting your time because you can calculate. So, use this relation over here and you can solve. My simple message is just create two equations in cases of calorimetric questions and get the solution. Yes, because calculations sometimes slightly long. So, my friendly suggestion for that particular aspect is please do some practice. Fine. Whenever you have some free time, do some practice of calculating fast, multiplying, dividing, adding and like that. Then students, this one is a question. Now, I picked this question from your one chapter, that is electromagnetic waves, small chapter, very small chapter, and just one or two formulae. Now, this whole chapter need hardly 20-25 minutes for revising properly. And the probability of getting a question from this chapter in medical entrance exam is very good. Reason is no why. Basic result, and as such no long calculations. Fine. So, it is a very fruitful particular topic. The question is, a 27 milliwatt laser beam has cross section area 10 mm square. The magnitude of maximum electric field in this EM wave is how much? Now, directly formula based question, and I am writing the formula as I is equal to 1 by 2 NC epsilon naught E square. Now, many of you may feel, sir, sometimes it's difficult to remember these formulae. Well, if these type of small chapters have just one or two basic results, so you just note down on a A4 size paper, and when you have some time, just take care of these particular aspects. Fine. As N is equal to 1 as per the question, and also students, we have a relation intensity I is equal to power upon E. So, from these two results, what I can say, equation number 1 is equal to equation number 2, very simply I can write down. So, I am writing this relation at this point, that is 1 by 2 C epsilon naught E square is equal to how much? P by E. And please don't get confused. This is energy. I think I should mention it like this so that there should not be any confusion. This is energy. Okay. And this E is electric field. So now I think no problem for any good student to put the values and solve it, fine. So our target is to find e square, that is 2 power upon speed of light into epsilon naught into energy. Sorry, it should be capital E, like this. Now, sometimes this is a problem. Why? Into 10 to the power minus 12. So my suggestion is, rather than writing this, you should write it as like this. That will make your calculation more simple. Fine. So you just put the value, because every value is given over here. So after putting the values, you will get the answer as 1.4 kilovolt per meter. Fine. I'm deliberately skipping calculation aspect, because if I'm telling you multiplying this with that, multiplying, so that is mere wastage of time. But if you wish for that calculation steps also, please feel free to mention on our website that from now onwards, please provide step by step solution. So I don't have any problem in mentioning those solutions. Fine. Now, question number 3. There is one chapter, a very simple chapter in your class 12 topic, that is dual nature of radiation and matter. And in that particular chapter, you have to find de Broglie's wavelength for various type of particles. So this question is directly based from that. Particle A, mass m, charge q, is accelerated by 50 volt. Fine. Particle B, mass 4m, charge same, q, accelerated by 2500 volt. You have to find the ratio of de Broglie wavelength, that is lambda A upon lambda B, nearly equal to. Now, students, please don't forget this result, that is lambda is equal to H upon P. Fine, H upon P, H upon mv, or in terms of kinetic energy, we can write this relation. So like that, if I am writing the final relation, then I can get the relation as mqv, mqv, okay. So it is for B, for B, for B particle. It is for A, for A, for A particle, okay. And now, I hope things are quite simple. MB, MA, that is M by 4M, QB, QB, QQ, QB, QA, and VB is how much? 2500, VA is how much? 50. So simply solve it, and lambda A upon lambda B, you will get it as 14.14 angstrom. Sorry, it is a ratio. So this is the value. Roughly like that. Fine. I mentioned the basic formula, then I mentioned the final result. I think remembering this result is quite easy. That's why I mentioned the formula in a specific fashion. A, B, MQV, MQV, then upside down. Okay. So by this method, you can save your time, because your NEET exam means 45 questions of physics you are supposed to answer in just 45 minutes. Question number 4. Now, this question I very specifically picked from your modern physics, that is nuclear physics, that is radioactivity. A simple question. Fine. In radioactive decay chain, initial nucleus is 90 Th 232 thorium. At the end, there are 6 alpha particles and 4 beta particles are emitted. And end nucleus is ZXA. Find the value of A and Z. Now, students, very simple result. Each alpha particle twice He4. Fine. So, 6 alpha particle means in atomic number, reduction should be 12. Okay. So, twice He4. It is 1 alpha particle. So, 6 means 12 and Then in upper portion it is going to be 6 4 = 24. So reduce this value from here. After reducing the value, you will get somehow like this over here. I think I should mention it properly. It should be 90 minus 12y. Fine, because new nucleus will come up. And 232 minus 24. After that, from this y, what will happen? Again, 4 beta particles. So, beta particles emission means what? Beta particles emission means this change in what is? That is 1 beta 0. So, from this particular aspect, I will say 78. And how much you will get over here? That is 232 minus 20, that is 210 minus 4, that is 206. Fine, 206. So ultimately you put the values 4 beta particles. Okay, final calculation will give me this value answer as 4th, that is 208, clearly visible over here, x. Fine, and z is equal to 80, 4 beta particles. Okay. So, these questions are not very difficult one, a very fundamental type of question approach, but sometimes calculation error will make these things difficult, okay. So, please avoid these things. Now, question number 5, class 11th SHM chapter. My simple question to all of you, is it possible for you to skip this chapter? Not at all. Fine. So, question is, a particle executes simple harmonic motion with amplitude 5 centimeter. When particle is at 4 centimeter from mean position, the magnitude of its velocity is equal to its acceleration. You have to find the periodic time in seconds. I will mention three simple formulae. First formula is x is equal to A cos omega, omega t, where A is amplitude, this is displacement, omega angular frequency, t is any time. Now, after this result, I will get V is equal to omega under root. From where I am getting this result? Just by differentiating it once. So, over here, if I put the value A square minus x square, simple result. And then students, acceleration A is equal to minus omega square A. So, these three results, if you are able to recall, then as per the question, what is given? That is mod of V is equal to mod of A. No problem. Put this value over here and put this value over here and solve it. So, you will get T is equal to 8 by 3 pi second. In this particular chapter, SHM, if you are able to recall these three results directly, because in examination hall it is not possible to differentiate it twice, to get acceleration, to differentiate it once, to get this velocity relation, better to remember it. Fine, a simple result. And then put the values. So, 8 by, you can say 3 pi, that is B is the correct option. Fine. So, five these questions, I tried my best to mention five very important topics, subtopics or chapters for your preparation. I hope you will try your best to attain good marks. Best of luck from our side. Take care of yourself. Have a nice time.